Hi, my name is Eves Karydas, and you're watching the Buzz Artist Spotlight.
Always thought when I sleep was meant to be peaceful, but my blood's been running. My teeth fall out in my dreams. Don't know what it means now, but it must mean something.
Congratulations on all your success with Complicated, because I've been hearing it nonstop on the radio here in Australia. So the support behind that is incredible here.
Yeah, it's been a real great year. Like, all things considered, you know, it's been such a wacky year for everybody, but that's been, I feel like, the silver lining of it all. Just, I think, the words in that song somehow connected on like a different level than if it had been released when there wasn't a global pandemic. I don't know what would have happened.
Yeah, it really did click with the audience. And how does it feel for you to listen to that on the radio, to hear your own song on the radio?
Yeah, it's pretty special, because my ambition from, you know, when I started out at all this when I was like 15, so 10 years ago, has always been like, I want to be on mainstream radio. I love radio music, so it's like such a career high for me. It's the first time I've ever really had something on, yeah, commercial radio around Australia. So fingers crossed I can keep it going with this next song that, yeah, just came out, yeah, just this week.
I got big emotions and they're taking up a lot of time. It's really eating into all the things I should prioritize. Never been impatient, but I'm shaking for another high.
So talk to me a little bit about this new song, Get Me So High. What was the inspiration like behind that song?
So I wrote this one in Stockholm as well. I wrote Complicated in Stockholm too. It just seems to be my sort of favorite place for finding like-minded writers and, I don't know, just people who love pop music the way that I do. So I found these two girls. The thing I really love about Get Me So High is that it's like an all-female creative team. Like, me and two other chicks wrote it, and Maddie, one of the writers, is one of the producers on the song. And it's just like, we need more of that in the industry. Like, it's just, it's a first for me as well. And I found that writing this song with them, we had like barely met, but we, you know, got in a room together, and, you know, as girls do, you just sort of like, you go for the emotional jugular, like within 5 minutes. It's like, oh, so who's broken your heart? So yeah, we just got along like a house on fire and started, we were all at a similar place in the relationships we were in, where we were feeling like a real lack of security and just felt like we were just becoming these sort of crazy versions of ourselves, because we weren't like getting the attention we wanted, or I don't know, didn't feel like we were being treated right, whether that's true or not. I keep thinking about it with this song, because I'm like, the relationship I was in was actually awesome, but I, in my own head, just made up all these like stories that I was like, I don't know, I think it was just self-consciousness coming through. But yeah, so we sat in the room, and then we just stayed up really late, and we were drinking rum and eating chips and just talking like nonsense, and we ended up with the song. So I'm really, really psyched that this is finally out, and I feel like people are really relating to the lyrics. I just really wanted it to be like little snapshots of very specific situations that I always find myself in when I'm sort of addicted to somebody, like worrying why they haven't replied to you really quickly, or like suddenly it's like, oh, I'm gonna cancel all my plans just to make myself free for like the 10 minutes that you happen to be free this week or something.
I feel like a lot of people will relate to that as well. And is this your second song that you've written with those writers, or what's, you know, what have you been working on with them? And
that was the first song we did as a team, the three of us, Maddie, Amanda and I. I'd worked with Amanda before, and Maddie, yeah, it was like one of my first times meeting her, but we've done a whole bunch of sessions since and cooking up a few other things. It's just been tough though, because this year obviously I can't be back over in Stockholm. So we've been doing loads on Zoom, which is really tough, but it's great when you know, and obviously they're my friends, so we just have a good time, and making music with friends is like the best thing ever.
Yes, yes. And being a singer-songwriter, how has your style evolved and changed over the past, say, 10 years?
Well, I started out, yeah, as you say, a singer-songwriter, and I played acoustic guitar and I would busk, and like my music was very, very inspired by like early Taylor Swift or like Joni Mitchell and Carole King, and even I was like obsessed with Neil Young at that age as well. And it was very acoustic and folk driven. And then I've, you know, been releasing music professionally for maybe 6 years now. And I think when I started doing it professionally, I sort of wanted to just sort of stretch my boundaries a lot more. So I've explored a whole range of different sonic palettes, but now I feel like with Complicated and Get Me So High, it's like finally hitting the nail on the head of like meeting my folky singer-songwriter roots with my love of radio pop. So, you know, you can hear the guitars and just like the singer-songwriter, like at their core, both of these songs are singer-songwriter songs. Like you could just play them on a guitar and you don't need production to really make the song work. So I'd say that's been my journey to this point.
I can't wait to see where that journey takes you and how it keeps evolving and how the palette keeps developing, you know?
Yeah, it's exciting. I think definitely like I'm still going down this road of like guitar-based music or guitar-based pop music and lyrics front and center, and it's just all very storytelling. It's about storytelling and it's confessional and it's I just love melodies as well. So I think people often talk about my music as like being like very melodically varied, which is and not just sort of simple. I don't know, it's hard for me to see it objectively, but
yeah. There's also that. Like vulnerability with it as well, and how you're, you know, you open up and you are vulnerable and then people will connect, like you were saying, you know?
Yeah, I hope so. I just hope that out of all of this, there's just a sense of relatability in what I'm writing, and that's all I can ask for, really.
Yes. Yeah. So what's next for you? Do you have local shows in Australia or virtual shows? You know, you're still writing. I saw that you're in Byron and you were recording. So that was exciting.
Yeah. Well, we're finally starting to talk about shows. It's been such a strange year for it. So fingers crossed, like start of next year, there'll be a couple of festivals that I'm doing. Yeah, we're talking about a headline tour as well. I don't really have any info yet, but it is being talked about. And also just wanting to get more music out there, because obviously like this year will have only been 2 singles. I mean, that was for a reason, like Complicated was just doing so well that we didn't really want to sort of move past it too quickly. But I think next year I would like to get like a whole lot more music out there just for people to sink their teeth into. And yeah, it's like so many shifting parts. So it's hard to say for sure, but it's all feeling really positive, especially down here in Australia, like things opening up and shows happening. Like I keep seeing like people in Perth going to festivals where there's like 15,000 people and stuff. And it's just so like surreal looking at it. But you know, good job on them for...
Fingers crossed it won't be too long till we can do that all around Australia, and we can have you touring all around Australia too.
I'm Eves Karydas, and you've just been buzzed.